All right, Kevin, thank you. So I'm a Texas girl at heart, and beef dishes are totally my thing. So this is the perfect Cook's Corner this afternoon. I'm joined by Adam Parker from Mountain View Grand. Thank you so much for joining us.
Oh, Linda, thank you for having me. This is my 14th time joining all of you here at Cook's Corner.
Oh, so you're a veteran now.
Oh, I like to think so. But we've got something very special. I figured we'd celebrate the 14th time with a nice filet mignon.
Absolutely. So how do we get started with this dish?
Well, first I started with, I grilled off the filet, and now I just heated it up in the pan a little bit to get it to that nice medium rare temperature.
Okay.
Garlic, salt, pepper, a little bit of olive oil, and now I've got some nice spinach in here. The problem a lot of people make with spinach is they tend to overcook it.
That's
so they just destroy all of those delicious vitamins and minerals that are in there. And we can't have that. My wife's a registered and licensed dietitian, so I have to be really careful about protecting all this delicious nutrients in here.
Absolutely. So you saute that.
Yeah, we just give it a little saute, and the key is, again, not to overcook it. We're just going to wilt it, just to add a little bit of color to it to get it nice and hot. And that's
garlic.
About all it takes, as you can see.
Garlic aroma is so good, too.
Oh, yeah, it really invites people into the kitchen. So this is one of my dishes. I've actually won a couple of different awards for it, which I'm very proud of.
Well, it smells delicious, so I could see why.
Thank you. I've got some, believe it or not, wild mushroom raviolis.
And you just go into those right into the saute
pan. I'm going to throw them right into the pan, and then I've got a pesto we make right there on site.
Uh-huh.
And we're just going to add a little bit of that to it. And so they're nice and hot from that boiling water.
And the wild mushroom, that's in season right now, right?
Oh, you can find wild mushrooms just about any time, but now's a great time to be finding them in the fall foliage hunts. So as you can see, nice and hot again.
Oh, and it
we'll
smells
put this
good.
Right on the side.
And they complement each other so well, the mushroom and the filet flavor.
Absolutely. And then we've got, this is one of our signature sauces, a tomato red pepper Diablo sauce, we call it. So tomato red pepper and cream all in there.
Do you have a food processor, or how do you blend that all up?
We've got this industrial-sized mixer that it's called a burr mixer, and it's like a big boat motor, if you can picture that, that we put in all these stocks and sauces.
Very nice.
Yeah, so I get lots of toys to play with. Every once in a while, I get a new one. So we'll drop our filet right on there, and I rested it for a minute just to try to get some of those juices from splattering everywhere.
Back into the meat.
Yeah.
Absolutely fabulous. And quickly tell us about some fall interesting things you've got
going
on.
Well, we've got chicken bowling, frozen chicken bowling that we're going to be doing once it gets cold enough. And we do New Hampshire axe throwing, and Miss Baker is phenomenal at it. She actually gave me some tips, so I didn't hurt anybody, believe it or not.
Sounds like a plan. Adam, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you, Linda.
Bon appetit, everybody.